As the man in black, I've always found listening to blues a relaxing experience, especially the voice of Robert Johnson.
I got to keep moving, I got to keep moving. Blues falling down like hail, blues falling down like hail.
Today's story concerns a certain American professor who shares my love of blues, but found his involvement far from relaxing.
And the day keeps on worrying me. It's a hellhound on my trail. Hellhound on my trail. Hellhound on my trail.
Carol Harper.
I gotta keep moving. Blues falling down like hell.
James.
Blues falling down like hell. Ooh.
James.
And the days keep on worrying me. There's a hellhound on my trail.
James, where are you?
Hazlehurst, Mississippi.
Oh.
Birthplace of Robert Johnson and home of Sonny Hines.
You got there.
Well, hell of a journey down here. I thought it was never going to end. How's it going?
Fine. So what's the motel like?
Ugly. And the air here is rancid, like everybody's been sucking on the same breath for the last 90 years.
When did you get in?
About 4 hours ago.
4 hours ago?
Hey,
what?
Remind me to recommend this place to Rylance and the American Literature Department when I get back. It's the kind of dump those guys would love.
So how come you didn't call until now?
I only just checked in. Yeah, I've been to every music store and club in Hazlehurst putting word out that I want anyone who knew Sonny Hines to contact me.
Even though he disappeared 28 years ago.
29.
Oh, some hope.
Well, Carol, I have to start somewhere. Hey, I even went down to where C.J. Hammond used to have his recording studio. And I found out that Hammond lived in Hazlehurst right up until he died in 1970. Sonny Hines cut his first demo acetates at Hammond's studio back in 56, way before he got involved in the civil rights movement. Yeah. Well, that was a depressing experience, though. Where the studio used to be is now a fast food joint.
Well, what did you expect, a monument?
I know, it's just... I had this crazy notion some of the sample records Hines cut at the studio might still exist, and I could put them out with the book when, if it's published. Oh, one good thing. I got the name of a guy who used to work as a recording engineer for Hammond. I'm meeting him at a gig he's doing tonight. You know, it sure feels good to be on the trail of this thing.
Sounds like you really miss me and the kids.
I said you should come along.
Have you lecture us about protest songs and the history of the civil rights movement all day long? No, thank you.
Well, you'll be sorry you said that when I prove the CIA murdered Sonny Hines and my book's at the top of the New York Times bestseller list.
Honey, I'll believe it when I see it. Just remember, you promised to spend some time with me before I lose you to your students again next week.
Listen, I'll be here 2-3 days at most. Then I'm all yours.
Promise?
Promise. Love you. How long did you say you knew C.J. Hammond, Mr. Anderson?
About 10 years. I used to go around and help out at the studio when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Late 50s. I was into the blues, and Hammond was the guy with all the records. Going way back.
And he was always talking about Sonny Hines?
Rarely talked about anything else. He was into Hines in a big way. Me too. Hines gave the guitar a voice that it never had before.
Right.
He was so inventive. All that string bending he got into his style.
And that incredible slide playing.
One day, I seen Hines go out back with an empty wine bottle, smash it against the wall, and then start cutting the neck down with a pair of pliers. 5 minutes later, he's recording using the brand new slide he just made for himself.
Oh, I didn't realize you actually worked in the studio with him.
Sure. Hey, you ever heard that song, that Robert Johnson song he covered, Hellhound on My Trail?
I was going to ask you the same question.
I was the engineer on the session Sonny first recorded his version of that song.
Well, before it was released as a single?
About 4 years before. Never would have guessed it was going to be his one big hit record.
Well, you know what I like best about it? The way Hines interpreted the lyrics, so it became a song about the civil rights movement.
He sure got in pretty deep with all them sit-ins and such like.
Yeah, he even sang it on the March on Washington in 63, 3 months before he disappeared.
Man, he was only at the start of his career, 26 years old. He could have made it all the way if only he'd had the chance.
You think there's any truth in the rumors he might still be alive?
No. That man lived for his music. He's long dead.
The party, the night Hines disappeared, did you go to that?
No, I didn't have nothing much to do with Hines after he moved on to New Orleans. You want my opinion? The Klan murdered him. Then they burned the body to hide the evidence.
Well, you don't think the CIA were involved? There seem to be a lot of conflicting reports.
I don't know. One thing I'm sure of, though. there was some evil about their business.
Evil?
Otherwise, people would have found out something by now.
James Harper?
Yeah.
Call for you.
I gotta get back to the band now. Been real nice talking to you. Recalling old times.
Sure. Thanks for taking time out. Excuse me.
Not set in 3 minutes. Over here, Mr. Harper.
Hello, James Harper speaking.
You the one wants to know about Sonny Hines?
Oh, that's right. Who is this?
You want to hear what I got to say or not?
Oh, sure. Sorry. Go on.
Mm-mm, not now. Tomorrow noon. Take a cab to the crossroads of Sagefield.
Pardon me?
Sagefield. 10 miles out of town. Stand with your back to the cab as it pulls away, then cross to the East Fork.
East Fork.
I'll be waiting.
Thanks.
You Harper?
Yeah. You always creep up on people like that?
Anybody know you come?
What's with the Cold War routine?
Why are you going around asking questions about Sonny Hines?
Well, I'm writing a book about protest music and the civil rights movement. Hines was a key figure.
What you mean by that, a key figure?
His songs. Most of his songs were overtly political. He was trying to get popular. A lot of people resented that. Listen, I don't think it's a coincidence that Hines disappeared at a time when his potential appeal could have stirred up a whole lot of trouble.
So what you think happened to him?
I think that someone wanted him out of the way. I think that someone murdered him and tried to implicate the Klan in some kind of a cover-up.
Wasn't no CIA, if that's what you mean.
How can you be so sure?
Tell me this, Mr. Ryder. Why is it people seem so interested in Sonny Hines all of a sudden?
Well, I don't know. Maybe because Hines went missing around the same time Kennedy was assassinated. The case never really got the exposure it should have got at the time.
Kennedy, Kennedy, Kennedy. All I ever hear is Kennedy. Why is it everybody's obsessed with Kennedy and Jack Ruby and that Lee Harvey Oswald? People are always making films and writing books about the same damn thing, and now it's Sonny Hines. Everybody writes books on this now. You ain't the first, mister. But I want to tell the truth. Not some pack of lies make out some sensational claim.
Did you know Hines?
Oh, I knew him all right enough. Sonny Hines was my half-brother.
Your half-brother? What was he like?
I ain't here to reminisce. There's things people got to know about Hines. See, I went to New Orleans after Sonny disappeared, see if I could find out what happened. I had in mind these two sisters, twins, Marcy and Trisha Singleton. Sonny'd been playing around with both of them. But it went deeper than that. I'd been with Hines a few weeks previous when Marcy comes up to him, plucks his fingers from his guitar, and calm as you like say she is going to kill him dead. She accused him of being with her sister, shouting he abused her and something about how if it weren't for her, he'd be nothing. But Sonny, he just keep right on playing. 2 weeks later, Sonny Hines is gone. The last anyone seen of him at a party in New Orleans, he's drunk, crawling around on his hands and knees and howling and snapping like a dog. Just like Robert Johnson was the way before he died. Yeah, you heard what they used to say about Johnson. Something about how he sold his soul to the devil at a lonely crossroads in return for an ungodly talent. When Sonny was a kid, he used to come out here every night waiting for that devil to show up. I used to follow him. Hines modeled himself on Robert Johnson. Everything Johnson did, he got to do. And he made his pact with the same devil, all right. A devil by the name of Marcy Singleton. I tell you, there was evil in that woman's eye. She poisoned him. That's how he died.
But how can you be so sure it was her?
I heard she was at the party with her sister. So I wait for her at the church I know she goes to. Then when she comes out, I go up to her. I can tell it's her from the eyes. Now she's real polite, because she don't recollect who I am. But when I say my name's Ike Roberts, and I ask how did she know what happened to Hines, she screamed like a mad woman. And the other one comes at me and tells me to get out with my bad mouth. But I'm convinced now it must be her, so I tell him I'm staying till I find out the truth about what happened. Oh, I had a whole lot of threats after that, people telling me to get out. But I'm persistent. I start to follow the twins everywhere they go. And that's how I came to be at that old sugarcane storehouse down on Lake Leary. I hear the sound of drums, so I follow it to this place. And I see these guys outside, they holding some kind of snake. Ooh, it's real long. And I get to thinking it ain't like no snake I seen before, but from what I know, I guess it must be some kind of python, but I can't think straight, because all the time these drums is going on, beating the same rhythm over and over. So when everyone's gone inside, I sneak up to take a closer look. Through a gap in the boards, I see all these people dancing like they was possessed. Oh, that's when I get to thinking about that snake worship and them people who believe in that Haitian voodoo. Ooh, and then I seen him, Sonny Hines, all laid out on the floor with them people cursing and stamping around his dead body. And there they were, the twins, sat there like they was God Almighty watching the whole damn thing going on in front of them. Somebody must have seen me, because suddenly there was people shouting outside at me. I started to run, but they came chasing after me. Felt like the devil himself was on my trail. I didn't know where I was going. I just kept stumbling, and they caught up with me and took me back and made me kneel in front of Marcy Singleton.
You should have left when you had the chance, Ike Roberts. Never would have come to this.
He out of his head. I don't think he's gonna do nothing.
Well, he seen us, didn't he? He'd been prying into things ain't none of his business. We just gotta make sure he don't never talk to no one about it. Leave him something to remember us by. Something to remind him if he ever says anything, he's dead. Hold his eyes open. That's it. You take a good look, Ike Roberts. That's right. Marcy gonna make you squeal. Hold him down. Yes. You've been bad coming here and sneaking round where you ain't wanted to. Don't you think I'm gonna do it? Huh? You'll only make it worse if you don't keep still. That's better. Now you let me press my thumbs down on your eyeballs. Was that too much pressure? That hurts?
Why are you telling me this?
I had enough. I want the truth out. Thing is, I don't care no more. I don't care if they come to kill me. I'm through with hiding my face away. You just remember I ain't never told none of this to no one before.
No, this is crazy. Why should I believe you?
Look into my eyes. What do you see? That's right. Not a pretty sight, is it?
How can I ever substantiate any of this? It's preposterous.
Go to New Orleans. It's your death sentence now, man. Not mine.
Yes, yes, I know it's insane, honey, but I have to go.
Have to?
It's only a couple more days, and it's a great angle for the book.
What book? You haven't even got a publisher yet. I mean, it might be different if you've been paid in advance or something. Besides, it sounds dangerous, Jimmy.
But this is just the kind of thing to get a publisher interested. I mean, I checked out the things this Roberts guy said. Haitian voodoo cults are known to have existed around New Orleans.
I just think you're wasting your time.
Listen! I could tie it in with other great possessed musical geniuses. Jimi Hendrix, Thelonious Monk.
Oh.
They even used to call the modulations Monk played zombie music. It has all kinds of possibilities, doesn't it?
I suppose you could always sell the story to the National Enquirer.
Oh, come on, Carol. Don't give me a hard time. This is something I want to do. For me. Is that so difficult to take?
I can understand you being interested in what happened to Hines, but this is becoming an obsession. I mean, what good's it gonna do?
It's not the point. Anyway, I have to go to New Orleans now. I've already contacted a guy there, a doctor, an expert on local black history. I've read a couple of his articles before, and he's supposed to have special interest in Hines.
Fine. Just call me when you feel like spending some of your vacation with your family.
Carol, I...
I'm sorry, Mr. Harper, but I repeat, Marcy Singleton didn't poison Hines.
But I've looked
into what happened that night more times than anyone else you're ever likely to meet. Marcy and Tricia Singleton weren't even at that party.
Are you sure?
Anyway, that theory's been discredited for years.
Is it possible to talk to either of them?
Not unless you know a very good spiritualist. They died in a house fire in 1981.
Oh.
There's still a cousin living here in New Orleans, though. Lucia Grange. My receptionist should have her address. Now, you'll have to excuse me.
Look, Dr. Lewis, I'll come clean. I have a theory that the CIA were involved. A lot of politically suspect people went missing in the 60s, and it wouldn't have surprised me to find Hines on their list.
Mr. Hart.
I met this old guy. Claimed to be Hines' half-brother. He told me Marcy Singleton poisoned Sonny Hines because he'd be messing around with her twin sister. And that was made worse by the fact that these women were involved in some kind of a voodoo cult. He then told me they blinded him to make sure he kept his mouth shut.
Mr. Harper, this sounds pure fantasy. Voodoo belongs to the 19th century.
Do you know much about it?
Well, to be honest, it sounds like this guy was off his head.
That was exactly my reaction. But I've done a lot of reading. Haitian voodoo cults did worship twins. People were seen to go into trances in precisely the way this guy Roberts described to me. Not only that, these cults claim to be able to reanimate a dead body by causing it to be possessed by any evil spirit. As I understand it, they would get their victims intoxicated in some way, then bury this person alive before returning to the grave sometime later to retrieve the body for the ceremony. Roberts told me he saw these people with a corpse that he recognized as Sonny Hines.
And you believe all of this?
Well, whether I believe it or not is irrelevant. The point is that there were people around who did believe and practice it.
You have a vivid imagination, Mr. Harper. Success. That was the only curse Sonny Hines ever knew. He was just typical of the kind of black kid who escapes poverty, gets a taste of success, and finds himself in a world he doesn't understand. He was a great talent, but he couldn't take it. He disappeared because he wanted to.
I can't believe that.
I'm sorry. I've got a surgery to run here. I'm very interested in Hines and his music, but not all these crazy conspiracy theories. Next, you'll have him sleeping with Marilyn Monroe.
Hi, you're through to the answering machine of James and Carol Harper.
Oh,
I'm afraid we're not able to take your call right now, but if you'd like to leave a message, please speak right after the beep.
Carol, I'm really on to something. I saw this doctor guy about Sonny Hines, and when I mentioned voodoo, he closed right up and said it wasn't a subject that interested him. I since found out that he published a book on voodoo worship in New Orleans under a pseudonym just 4 years ago. Now, when I called him to ask about it, he got real angry and refused to speak to me. There's something real strange going on here, Carol. I don't know who's involved or what it is, but I sure as hell intend to find out. I'll call again later. Yeah, bye. Love you. Kiss the kids. I wonder where she is. Yes? James Harper? Hello?
Leave now and you won't come to no harm.
Who is this?
Leave now.
Lucia Grange?
That's right. You must be that book writer.
James Harper. May I?
Sure. Sit yourself down on the porch. You want a beer?
Oh, why not?
So what is it you want from me?
Well, I'm told you were related to Marcy and Tricia Singleton.
That's right.
You spent much time with the twins?
No. Never had much to do with my side of the family. They were sure strange, though, that much I know. Here.
Thanks. Oh, wow, that's good. This heat sure is something. Strange. In what way, Miss Grange?
Well, for one thing, they used to go to all the funerals there was around here, whether they was family or not. And they was always at church on Sundays and all, but they sure were no Christians.
Oh? What makes you say that?
I seen the way they prayed. They didn't believe in no God I ever heard of. And I'm a religious woman, Mr. Harper.
You ever know a musician called Sonny Hines?
I heard of him.
You remember him being around?
Listen, I don't know what happened to Hines, but I do know it won't do no good asking questions about him around here.
But what's that supposed to mean? I've already been told to leave town.
You still don't get it, do you? Marcy and Tricia was protected. That's how come nothing ever got said about Hines. And nothing ever will.
Protected?
The Singleton women been involved in voodoo for generations. It's passed on. They look after their own. especially twins, even when they're dead. You end up taking one hell of a beating if you don't tread careful.
You mean this cult still exists?
You don't have to believe it if you don't want. That Dr. Lewis already had threats. Muster. Otherwise, why'd he call me up and tell me not to speak to no James Harper? And they've been getting at you and all. Take my advice, Mr. Harper. You hightail back home. Leave New Orleans while you can.
Excuse me, are there any messages for me? Room 215, Harper?
I'll just check, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, there's a note for you, sir. I think someone delivered it by hand. Hey, are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine. I just got a lot of things in my mind. Thank you.
Is there a problem, sir?
Well, it seems I'm not too welcome around here. It's a note telling me to get out. Yes. Who is this?
James. I got your message on the answer phone. James, is that you?
Yeah. I thought you might be someone else. I keep getting these calls.
What calls? You sound awful.
I've been wiped out, that's all. I haven't had too much sleep the last few days.
Oh, James.
Hey, guess what? If Sonny Hines wasn't mixed up in voodoo himself, it's almost certain the Singleton twins were. Carol, it's not as crazy as it all sounds. I've been getting threats.
Threats? What kind of threats?
Well, phone threats. Notes. They're trying to scare me.
I told you not to.
There are people here who don't want me around, but I'm not giving in. Not till I found out what happened to Hines.
This whole thing is getting out of hand. Why must you go digging up stuff that happened 28 years ago?
29, Carol.
Oh, for God's sake, leave it. Back off. It gives me the creeps. It always has.
I have to find out what happened to Hines. I can't just stop, not now. I owe it to Hines and all the people who care about him and his music to find out what happened. People have the right to know.
James! Leave this. Promise me that please, James, come home.
No, I can't. I'm too close. Look, I have to go now. There's someone at the door. Well, come in.
Mr. Harper, I want to apologize. I was a bit abrupt earlier. See, I didn't think anyone else knew about the Singleton twins. It all happened so long ago. I've been researching their involvement with Hines for a couple of years now.
No. Oh, excuse me. James Harper.
For God's sake, what are you trying to prove?
Oh, leave it, Carol. I can't talk
James,
now.
I'm worried about you. Who are these people that are after
Look,
you?
I'm busy. There's someone here.
Stop it, James. Stop it. Leave now. We need you. Just get your things together and get out.
Look, I'll call later.
I think, Mr. Harper, I know where Hines was murdered. You okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Follow me.
Lucia Grange said you'd been threatened as well.
There's no such person as Lucia Grange, Mr. Harper. The woman you saw this morning was Marcy Singleton.
Marcy? I don't...
Tricia Singleton lives in Baton Rouge.
You trying to tell me that what Robert said was true?
Most of it. Hines had been Marcy's lover for quite some time. She always put up with his sleeping around, but not when it came to her twin sister. It was an insult to the cult, as well as the twins. Marcy poisoned him, but she didn't kill him. He died from asphyxiation.
Asphyxiation? How?
Just keep walking, Mr. Harper.
Oh. My head, it feels like I'm gonna...
Oh. Probably the heat. You'll be all right once we get inside.
Hey, what's that noise? Lewis, I'm talking to you.
I thought you might like to be present at one of my ceremonies.
What?
You see, Mr. Harper, I am a high priest. What we call a Bokor.
What have you done to me? Oh, no. No, I can't think straight.
He seen us, didn't he? He added his heel. I don't think he's gonna do nothing. The way they pray. You should have left when you had the chance. Never would have come to this.
No!
She poisoned him. That's how he died.
Roberts, is that you?
Roberts is dead.
Dead?
Look into my eyes. What do you see?
No. No!
Hold him!
Get off! Get off of me! You'll never get away with this!
Get away with what? People disappear all the time, Mr. Harper. You can blame the CIA or whoever you like. It still happens. Get him inside!
I can't see him. Oh, my head. What? Dark, it's so dark. What is this? Huh? Stay calm. What happened? Lewis, I was with Lewis. I had a blackout. Roberts is dead. No. Think. Lucia Grange. Singleton. She gave me that drink. It must have been her. A sedative, a drug, something. Oh, my head. I can hardly breathe in here. Oh, God, what did he say? He died from asphyxiation. Oh, no. No. Oh, compose yourself. They just want to scare me. I'll push them. All right. You've had your fun. You can let me out now. Listen, I've had enough of this. I think straight, breathe easy. Yeah, steady, slow breaths, be positive. I'll let them know I've come around. Yeah, that'll do it. That'll let them know the game's up. There's no need to panic, just hold on. Hold on. They'll let me out. I've got no troubles, no worries. All my life, I've been a traveling man, staying alone and doing the best I can. Oh, come on! Come on, you bastards! They're obviously going to leave it until the last second and then let me out. That's it. Yeah, they're going to try and make me freak. Think of good things. Sun. Yeah. Bright sun, yes. Colors. Think of colors. Red, green, yellow, red, red. Think of red things. Redwood, red hair, green. Green grass, leaves. That's good. Country. Green. Trees, farms, fields. I've lost it. Oh, Carol. I'm sorry, Carol. I haven't done anything. I don't give a shit about any of this. Let me out. This is what they do. Anybody gets close to the truth of them. Please, oh God, oh God. I'm going to die. I'm going to suffocate. Asphyxiate. Oh, that my head will water. And mine eyes a fountain of tears that I might weep night and day. Oh, no! You can't do this to me. Let me out, please, let me out. You don't understand what you're doing. No!
Poor Carol Harper never did discover what happened to her husband. He was just buried in the files of missing persons.
Let me out!
James Harper was played by Nigel Anthony. His wife Carol, Shelley Thompson, Ike Roberts, Eric Ray Evans, Anderson, Bert Caesar. Dr. Lewis, John Rowe, Lucia Grange, Alib Parsons, Marcy Singleton, Sandra James Young, Tricia Singleton, Victoria Carling. The barman and receptionist, Jonathan Taffler. Hellhound on My Trail was written by Paul Syrett and directed by Martin Jenkins. I am Edward D'Souza, the man in black. My story next week is one of obsessive jealousy, which takes us backstage at a London theatre long after the lights have gone out.